Hello friends, I am Umakant Kadam and welcome on YouTube channel English and You. Let's start elements and types of drama.
Hello friends and welcome on YouTube channel English and You. Friends, on this YouTube channel you can see videos of English language and literature. If you have not subscribed our channel, please subscribe it and click bell icon. Friends, today we are going to learn elements and types of drama. Let's see what is drama. Drama is one of the important genres of literature. It is made to perform by actors on a stage. Let's see elements of drama. Elements of drama are plot, characters, dialogue, setting, theme, and conflict. First element of drama is plot. Like novel, it has types simple or complex. Plot may be tragic or comic. Plot which ends with sorrowful events is called as tragic plot, and plot which ends with happy events is called as comic plot. According to Aristotle, plot is more important than characters. For example, Arthur Miller's Death of a Salesman has tragic plot. Next element of drama is characters. Characters play an important role in a drama. Novelist or dramatist, both of them, they can show their thoughts, their views with the help of characters in drama or novel. Here, in drama, characters are important because they perform on stage and indirectly they reflect thoughts of that dramatist. Characters, there are two types of characters, flat characters and round characters. Characters who do not change in the course of action are called as flat characters, and characters who change in the course of action are called as round characters. For example, Shakespeare's The Merchant of Venice has various types of characters. Antonio, Bassanio, Portia, all these characters play an important role in that drama because they show Shakespeare's thoughts and views, his imagination, his feelings on stage. Next element of drama is dialogue. Characters communicate among themselves, and due to it, we can notice nature, behavior of that character. Here, character's personality is revealed with the help of dialogues. So, it's very important. In a novel, it is also one of the important elements, and in drama, it plays a vital role. Next element of drama is setting. In a novel, that novelist describes geographical location of that particular place as setting. In drama, setting is also important. Stage direction or setting plays a vital role in drama. For example, in Shakespeare's plays, battlefields, forest, court, palaces, etc. are used as setting. Due to setting or stage direction, we can understand that particular scene or that particular situation. So, setting plays very important role here. Next element of drama is theme. It is the central idea of that drama. It is a general statement about literary work. The dramatist handles one or more themes in a drama. For example, in Importance of Being Earnest, love and marriage are themes. Shakespeare also handles various types of themes in a drama. Love, lust, revenge, etc. are major themes in Shakespeare's dramas. Next element of drama is conflict. Conflict is the soul of drama. It has two types, internal conflict and external conflict. Internal conflict is in the mind of that particular character, while external conflict is between two or more characters. For example, in Shakespeare's King Lear, we can notice internal as well as external conflict. And in A Death of Salesman, there is internal conflict. So friends, these are elements of drama. Let's see types of drama.
Types of drama are tragedy, comedy, tragicomedy, farce, absurd drama, melodrama. And friends, besides these, Mask, Miracle Plays, Morality Plays, Sentimental Comedy, Problem Play, etc. are other types of drama. But in today's video, we are going to focus on only tragedy, comedy, tragicomedy, farce, absurd drama and melodrama. So let's start. What is tragedy? It is full of serious events and it ends with sorrowful events. It shows incidents in the life of central character with the serious style. Sometimes death, horror, violence, etc. are important elements in tragedy. Thomas Keats' The Spanish Tragedy, William Shakespeare's Hamlet, Macbeth, King Lear, Henrik Ibsen's A Doll's House, etc. are important examples of tragedy. Next type, that is comedy. Let's see what is comedy. In comedy, there is happy atmosphere. It ends with happy events. We have seen tragedy. Tragedy ends with serious events and it is totally opposite to tragedy. Comedy ends with happy events. In some comedies, love, humor, marriage, satire, etc. are important elements. Shakespeare's A Midsummer's Night's Dream, Ben Jonson's Holpone, William Congreve's The Way of the World, etc. are examples of comedy. The Way of the World is restoration comedy. Next type of drama is tragicomedy. Let's see what is tragicomedy. In tragicomedy, there are tragic and comic events. Events are related to all types of people. Plot of tragicomedy is serious as well as comic. As its name suggests, tragicomedy is full of serious and happy events. So plot is serious as well as comic. For example, William Shakespeare's The Merchant of Venice. Next type of drama is farce. Let's see what is it. In farce, there is only laughter, and the purpose of the dramatist behind it only to create laughter. In farce, there are comic events as well as comic characters. Importance of Being Earnest by Oscar Wilde is an example of farce. Next type, that is absurd drama. Let's see. In absurd drama, dramatist shows absurd condition of life. It means futile and meaningless human life is one of the important elements in absurd drama. Pessimistic tone is used by the dramatist in absurd drama. And the characters which are picturized, which are shown by the dramatist in absurd drama, they are helpless. For example, Samuel Beckett's Waiting for Godot, Harold Pinter's The Birthday Party, Albee's The Zoo Story, etc. are examples of absurd drama. Next type, that is melodrama. Let's see. In melodrama, there are tragic events. Murders, bloodshed, etc. are important elements in it. Intrigue, revenge, cruelty, etc. are also important elements in melodrama. The Duchess of Malfi by Webster, The Spanish Tragedy by Kidd, etc. are examples of melodrama. So friends, this is enough for today's lecture. I think you have enjoyed this lecture. And if you have not subscribed our channel English and You, please subscribe it and click bell icon. And other videos of English literature as well as English language are available on this YouTube channel. You can watch this. Thank you very much.